friends, and welcome to the 83rd episode of the Intermission Show at SLO REP. It is Friday, April 2nd, 2021, and we have an absolutely April-celebrating, vaccine-generating, my Kia Soul is quickly depreciating show for you today. Like every single thing we do within these four walls at SLO REP, this show would not be possible without the support of some generous sponsors and donors who've been tuning in once, twice, three times a week since we started this show last year.
I'm gonna soak up the sun, gonna tell everyone to lighten up.
It is time for our sponsor spotlight. Today's episode of the Intermission Show has been generously sponsored by everyone's favorite art lovers, philosophers, and 7-time sponsors of the Intermission Show over the last 12 months, Stephen Lloyd Moffitt and Amy Hart. Stephen and Amy have made this donation possible by giving up piña coladas.
If you like piña coladas, getting caught in the rain. If you're not into yoga,
why does Rupert Holmes look like my 8th grade algebra teacher?
Stay on target, Kevin.
Thanks, Billy! Stephen and Amy would like to make sure this donation supports the Fund to Support Billy Breed for a Tony Award.
Yes!
No way, Breed! We're putting that money directly back into the operation of this theater, Billy Breed. The Tonys will just have to wait.
Even this Tony?
This is your private chamber.
Tony, you are the housekeeper, and this is part of the house. Now, the private chamber may be mine, but the dust is yours.
Well, I'm sorry. Hey, you want me to come in here and clean? I'll come in here and clean.
I want you to. I want you to. And, Tony, same thing goes for my bathroom.
Oh, hey, the bathroom? Don't you have things in there that are too personal to mention, you know?
Just clean it and don't mention it.
Gee, what a great tub, eh? I mean, a walrus could bathe in there, huh? Oh, no offense. Oh, wait a minute. Laundry? Don't you have your dainties in there? You don't really want me to wash your skivvies, do you?
He's a bad housekeeper.
Thank you so much, Stephen and Amy, for everything you've done for this theater and for making this episode possible. We're going to check in again with Michael Brusasco and Melinda Parrett as they turn the heat up on part 5 of the Slow Rap Hot Ones Challenge. And yesery, Robert, it is our favorite day of the week. It is
Friday!
Which means it's time to beam KERRY DIMAGGIO into the program to introduce some remarkable young artist. And again, now that we passed the 1-year anniversary of the shelter-at-home shutdown, we thought that it would be the perfect time to jump back into our artist spotlight segment to check in with one of our favorite performers, musicians, and if this picture is accurate, person most likely to help you take care of that little problem, Ryan Loyd. And finally, we'll turn the Slow Rap spotlight toward another amazing BIPOC playwright as we look at Francisca da Silveira's 2018 masterpiece, Heritage Hill Naturals. Thank you so much for joining us. We are so happy that you're here. All right, campers, we have a jam-packed show, so let's hop right to it. Let's see how our good buddies Michael and Melinda are doing as they move on to hot sauce number 5. It is time for the Slow Rap Hot Ones Challenge.
Mm. It kind of comes.
Normally when I do a show and I'm done early and I just have the monitor, I'm like reading online, doing something, working on some costume, like totally. And more often than not, I would find myself watching the monitor for the whole end of the show because you were so good.
Oh.
Specifically in the moments where you have nothing to say, like where it was all the business about like hiding the key and trying to find out, you know, what Clifford's whatever the thing said, and like all of that whole thing was so well crafted and so entertaining to watch, even on a little screen backstage.
The phone call, that monster phone call I had to do, and you making drinks. And
my plastic ice cubes.
Your plastic ice cubes. But like from that point, because that, from that to after, like that whole section before the kid comes in, that was like some of my most favorite, like working with you. That was, because it was just so much fun.
Well, you also have to like listen.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Michael and Melinda. We'll check back in with you next week as temperatures will be raised. As inhibitions will be lowered. All right, everybody, it is our favorite day of the week. It is Friday.
Oh, yeah, throw your neighborhood in the air. If you don't care, oh, yeah, throw your neighborhood.
Which means it's time to beam Kerry DiMaggio into the show. It is time for our ACT Spotlight.
Welcome to ACT Spotlight, everyone. We are so proud to have been able to offer students fun and educational theater lessons and projects throughout this past year, and we're even more proud of the incredible work that they've done completing these challenges. From musical theater singing and dance to prop design, from Foley art to stage combat, our students have done it all. Take a look at their talent and creativity in some of my favorite moments from ACT Spotlight.
Either or, merry well, social world, businessman, clever girl, or paint my future on a green glass love. What kind of life am I dreaming of? I say,
here I am, Saint Valentine.
We've been stuck at home, my grandma taught me how to sew masks. First, she showed me how to cut the fabric and ties we were using to make the masks. Then she taught me how to pin and sew the masks. It took a while before I could sew a straight line. After we made masks for our community, we decided to make a quilt. This was much harder because there were a lot more pieces to deal with and way more sewing. Over just a few days, my grandma and I had cut, pinned, pieced together, and sewn an entire quilt. And now it's off to the quilters.
Hello everyone, it's London. Before COVID-19 came into town, Templeton is going to hold a film festival for students in the grades K through 12. I submitted a short film for this film festival, but sadly due to COVID-19 events, it was canceled. But I wanted to share my film with you guys, so here's my short film, The Understudy. Obviously gonna get the lead, but
you think you're pretty smart.
Tree number two? Tree number two! I'm not even tree number one! Ah!
She wraps the cord around her.
Tree number one, yes!
Tries hard to find a little thing.
Thank you.
It's the hard knock life for us. It's the hard knock life for us. Stay.
ukulele for the bling of the cuckoo bird that comes out. And this is a pot of coins and a lid on top, and you shake it, and that's when the coin goes down the machine. And this is a coin on top of a metal plate, and you hit it, and that's the coin placement.
So I use this jar lid and I guess something else for the jar lid too. So I just click it in here for when he closes the slot for the coin. Then I use this this kazoo for the reveille.
Hope you enjoy our film.
Bye.
Hey guys, it's London. This week, our assignment was folio art, so let's get into it. Thank you so much. Bye.
Thank you so much to all of the students who have participated in the ACT Spotlight Challenges. As Kevin says every week, we have loved seeing your work. All right. And just as a reminder, we have some really excellent in-person theater education opportunities coming up. We hope that you will join us for ACT's Spring Break Camp or our after-school spring class session or our ever-popular summer camps. All of the information and registration is available on our website, slorep.org. Thank you so much for joining ACT Spotlight this week. Bye.
Let's take a second to check in with one of our favorite Slow Rep friends. Let's see how Ryan C. Lloyd has been navigating this one-year anniversary of the shutdown. It is time for our Artist Spotlight.
Hello, Slow Rep friends and family. My name is Ryan C. Lloyd with Rilo Media Design in beautiful, sunny Los Osos, California. I'm a big fan and friend of Slow Rep and the Intermission Show. I've taken photos of past performances, plenty of them over the years. Used to be involved in the No Shame Theater back in the day. That was a lot of fun. But I was thinking about the other day and how weird this year is that it has been over a year since I've taken a photograph of a human being with something else other than my phone. I mean, I take pictures of my kid and myself a lot and my pets, but as far as work with the stage, the last show that I shot was always Patsy Cline. Well, I did shoot some outdoor stuff for a Valentine's event for that show, but that was the last time I photographed anything on stage with my camera that's not my phone. I don't know. And another weird thing is that I haven't really submitted any video to the show. I have, interesting fact, I'm in every episode, or at least my work is, all the bumpers in between. That's my handiwork, some fun I did. Every time Kevin asks to do something, if I'm not busy, I will do it. And definitely in a pandemic, I'm not busy. I've lost about 50 pounds just one day in July. I was like, I have to do something other than sit around and binge watch TV all the time. I mean, I still do that. And I just started walking, and I just haven't stopped. Since then, I think I've over 600 miles or something strange like that. I threw this. Let's get back to having some live shows. It'll be fun. Let's be cautious. You know, wear a mask. Wash your hands. Bye, everybody.
All right, it is time to highlight some essential BIPOC voices in theater. Today's featured artist is Francisca da Silveira. Da Silveira is a double graduate of NYU's Tisch School of the Arts, and she serves as the literary manager for Company One Theater. She draws inspiration from Anton Chekhov and Alan Bennett and is developing a new play about climate change with Flat Earth Theater and the Museum of Science. Heritage Hill Naturals opened at the Fresh Ink Theater in 2018. In an effort to avoid confronting her declining mental health, recent college graduate Lucilia volunteers a month of free labor to an organic farm in Georgia. There she encounters ignorance bordering on racism, religious fanaticism, and two healthy eating habits that force her to question whether escaping into a world of green living was really an escape at all. You can order a copy of this groundbreaking script at the link in the description. All of us here at Slow Rep encourage our patrons to get to know this important play. That'll wrap up today's episode of the Intermission Show at Slow Rep. Thank you so much to Amy Hart and Stephen Lloyd Moffat for making this episode possible. You have made every single person here at the Intermission Show feel more inept than Ted Knight on the Mary Tyler Moore Show.
And what's more, you'll gain from knowing all this because you'll know that you're a real man.
Oh, Lou. Why me, Lou? Why me? What if I send and deserve this?
Ted, I haven't told it to you yet.
You mean it gets worse?
Ted, you're not getting a Teddy Award. You weren't nominated this year. I'm sorry, but there will be other years.
And as always, thank you to all medical personnel, essential workers, county and city officials, and everyone who is working around the clock to bring this crisis to an end as soon as possible. We cannot thank you enough. Thanks so much for joining us, everyone. Hug who you are allowed to hug. And we will see you next week. Have a great weekend. Wear your mask.